Many of you probably have heard of the Rosetta probe, this probe that was launched to reach a comet. As the mission ended on the 30th of September, I want to give you a brief overview of what it was. This is Monterey, and welcome to my cosmic kingdom. The Rosetta mission is a mission that has been in space for 12 years. There is a lot of time, but on top of that, you need to put probably 10 extra more years of designing and manufacturing the probe. What is astounding that about this Rosetta mission is like we shoot a probe that was intended to reach a comet. Imagine having to just shoot something and where the target is so far away. But not only that, the target is moving, and it's moving at an astounding speed. So in order to catch it, you need to put the probe at more or less the same speed as the comet, and that was difficult to do. And also, the space in which the probe is going to travel is not going to be empty. It's going to be full of other planets. So as you can see here in this video, the calculations of the orbit of Rosetta were not simple. That is the physics. That is Newton physics, a little bit more complicated, some perturbations and etc. But that is something that many of us can do on a computer. But there is, for me, as an electric engineer, there is another astounding fact. Because they didn't want to increase the payload of the launcher, they didn't want to make the probe very heavy, they designed it so that it was going to be off for 7 years. So it was supposed to be hibernating for 7 years, and then to be awakened by a remote command given from the Earth when it was millions of kilometers away. That is incredible. And it worked. It worked. And not only that, when reaching the asteroid, the Rosetta probe had a small kit called Philae that was intended to land on the comet and extract information. It's still early to have all the results from the mission, even though it was finished on the 30th of September, but you know that we scientists love to take a little bit of time to process it, and then we have to go through the peer review processing that can be long. But what are the main objectives of Rosetta? Well, basically, they wanted to see a comet, because yeah, we have seen them. But for me, for instance, if you have a look at these images, I didn't know. I kind of imagine comets like a ball of ice with no structure. And this looks like more like the moon, like with ridges and valleys and mountains and things like that. So for me, that is astounding. But also, they were thinking that probably they will have the comets, because they have water and oxygen, they will have complex molecules there. And that is what they found, that they found like a lot of molecules, complex molecules that can live to life, if you want to put it that way, are in on the surface of the comet. Especially they found a big amount of O2, of oxygen, as we breathe in on Earth. And I think that is fantastic. So from my humble videolog, I want to congratulate ESA, the European Space Agency. And I want to remind you that all of you that are in Europe have contributed to one of the biggest feats of mankind, which was like launch a probe, catch a comet that was moving, and spend a year or so like doing research, taking pictures and taking data that was sent back to Earth. With that, I will be happy to hear your comments, see your suggestions, and see you next week, guys. Bye-bye.